listening to the Intestinal Fortitude Podcast Network.
Showing results for Is It Really That Bad?
In the tradition of E.T. and Close Encounters of a Third Kind.
What in the world?
Will I ever see you again?
Who knows, Highlander? Who knows?
Shouldn't play with sharp objects.
I really shouldn't even let you go after that shit you told me at school.
Oh, no, please.
No, tomorrow things are going to change around here, so I suggest you give it up tonight.
A warrior trained to the ancient art of combat.
A man needs his exercise.
Is it really that bad?
Yeah, it was. Very stupid.
Hey, everybody, welcome back to Is It Really That Bad? And tonight I'm joined by the cast and crew of Is It Really That Bad? It's been a while since we've all been together. Kenno?
True that.
Yes. Fucking true that. So just as a reminder for our million and one listeners, we're going to go down the bench and we're going to fucking announce everybody on the show tonight so nobody's confused. So first up, my right hand, left hand, middle arm sister, Sam, how you doing?
I'm doing pretty good. How are you?
Good. It's great seeing you when you were here, by the way.
It was awesome being there.
Yes, I missed you. I don't know if I got a proper booby hug from you. I might have. But
you got a feel, so.
Oh, I forgot. Oh, yeah, I got to feel your tits. I totally forgot.
How could you forget that?
Yeah, really.
Wow.
Oh, my God.
I smacked my ass, and you felt my tits?
Yes, I did. I did feel your tits. I totally. Mona's like, how'd you forget that? I was like, I don't know, Mona. I did. So,
wow.
I know. What a fuck. You know, that means I'm getting old. Like, I totally forgot I felt Sam's tits. They were nice and heavy, though, Sam. I will say that. So
old senile man wouldn't even forget that.
Fuck. Yeah.
I'm such wasted that on him, Sam.
No, I remember now. So, okay. So now
I remember now.
Burned into Newty's eyes.
No, it wasn't. Okay. Sam's tits were nice. They're heavy. And I appreciate that, Sam, very much. Thank you very, very much.
Anytime.
Thank you.
Anytime.
All right. So, we'll just announce Mona. How you doing, Miss Magpie Monotone? The Monotone?
Miserable, like always. Thank you.
She's A-okay.
She's
wonderful.
All right. We just found out that Mona had another maintenance man. Oh, yeah, she's pregnant, Rachel said. Yeah.
Rachel said, I hope not.
Yeah. You can't get pregnant through the asshole, though.
Schneider 2.0.
So,
miracle.
Yeah. All right. And straight out of the fucking devil's anus, where it's really hot in Arizona, Mr. Flesheater, how are you doing, sir?
Yes, I am doing well. It is I, Lord Flesheater. And I have power over millions here in Phoenix.
Is it hot?
Oh, yes. It's like 150 degrees. It's hotter than two hells out here.
There you go. Two hells. All right. And, straight from the East Coast, somewhere in the wasteland of a future zombie apocalypse because they've built so much shit up there. Mr. Willis, how you doing, sir?
Dummy, yeah.
You've been waiting for that one, huh?
Yeah.
He's catching on, huh?
Well, he been catching on. Me and Newty used to like him when he was on NWA.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
He's catching on.
He's from my neck of the woods. He's from Gaithersburg, Maryland.
Oh, really?
Yep.
Emphasis on gay. All right, so. All right, and
it's
Mr.
The gay lesbird.
Yeah. Mr. Newty.
Mm-hmm.
How you doing, sir?
I am doing wonderful. Cannot wait to do this movie you haven't named yet.
Oh, we're going to name it. Hey, I changed my name in Plex because somebody changed my name to the edgy one.
I did that like 7 years ago.
Oh, okay, because I changed my nickname to Scream Sucks.
Oh, yeah. Scream Sucks.
All right. Is there a conversation about it?
Well, they posted. They answered you, but you never answered back.
Oh, what did they say?
Nothing great.
I'm about to go over it. Yeah, I don't pay attention to those fucking idiots. All right. up next is Uwe Boll. 2009 movie.
Oh, and no, it's an Uwe Boll movie. This shit's really gonna suck.
Well, we don't know yet. We don't know yet.
I've heard Flesh Eater smoked Uwe Boll.
Yeah. And with that being said, it's gonna be 2009's Rampage. It's an action film, and it is written directed by Uwe Boll. And it's got some, you know, it's got Brendan Fletcher, and he's been in quite a few movies. And it's also Brendan Fletcher. He's an actor.
Freddy vs. Jason.
Freddy versus Jason.
He plays like crazy guys.
Yeah, he's in a lot. He was in Ginger Snaps 2, another Ginger Snaps movie. A lot of shit, bro. A lot of movies. So he was even in Blood Rain 2, by the way. I don't know if you guys know that. And Blood Rain, the Third Reich.
Oh,
really good
my
movies.
God.
Is that we haven't watched that? Those.
Yeah. I don't know. He does
that's
movies.
Not that
though.
Movie, is it? Cemetery Gates.
It's a video game movie.
Yeah. Is it a video game vampire movie?
Yes. Yeah.
I haven't even played the video game. I heard those were terrible.
They were.
Okay.
The first movie with Lucy Liu or whatever her name is.
Yeah.
Lucy Liu.
The Asian chick that was in Kill Bill.
Oh, I love Lucy Liu. She's the best.
I think she was in Blood Rain, right?
Yeah.
Is she?
She's the best.
I've not seen the second or third one, but
yeah.
I think I saw the first one.
Yeah, she's the best. It's a 2000. It does have a couple of sequels. I don't know anything about those, but Michael Paré, he's Mona's lover from fucking Streets of Fire. So he's in this too.
Desire?
Streets of Desire.
Eddie and the Cruisers.
Yeah.
44.
Yeah. Michael Paré.
A lot of stuff. Yeah.
Big Bad Wolf.
Beautiful.
Yeah. The last movie I saw him in was, what was it called? It was a sci-fi movie.
Cool story, bro.
No. I forget. Anyways, it was a sci-fi movie, and I think it was called...
Take another gummy. Maybe it'll help with your memory.
What? I have a good memory. What are you talking about?
You do not. You don't even remember Sam's tits. Yeah. You're lying now. He's lying now.
Yeah, sorry. Maybe, yeah, it could be something. I don't know. Anyways...
You know where you're at.
Sometimes I don't. I woke up the other night, and I didn't know where I was at. It was really scary. It's probably the medication, I'm thinking. I don't know. I'm very forgetful these days. Maybe it's an early onset of Alzheimer's, which I'm hoping for, because I won't remember my death. So there you go.
Or your kids, or your 45 grandkids, or your wife, or your podcasting friends.
It's okay. He'll get that all back afterwards.
Yeah, I'll remember all the blowjobs though. Thank you, Willis. So.
Bullshit.
All right, guys. So is everybody queued up and ready to go?
Yes.
All right. So 3, 2, 1, and go.
Thunderbirds are go.
Where's Willis? Crickets.
Never even answered.
Right here.
You're right. I'm pissed.
Shit.
Yeah, I didn't even see those Scream Sucks responses, but that's fucking funny.
I was like, oh, here we go.
Oh, well, you know.
Academy Award winning director, Uwe Boll.
Uwe Boll. This is going to suck. I have a feeling.
I went and saw that Alone in the Dark at the theater.
No!
So did I.
That's terrible. Yeah. Time that.
Presents.
I got worse than that. I actually went to see the House of the Dead at the movie theater.
Oh, I saw that too.
I kind of felt like that was kind of fun.
Oh, this guy's burning clothes. Something's going on.
Are we watching fucking Gummo again?
Let's hope so.
Oh, that guy's in usually most of his movies. I want to watch Blubberella again.
Oh, that's
one of my favorites.
Blubberella?
I love Blubberella.
I've never heard of Blubberella.
That he does.
All right, so we got a van driving into a bank blowing up or something.
Ooh.
What's Blubberella?
It's another Uwe Boll movie.
Really?
Yeah, I love it. Google it. It's so awful. It's great.
I'll do it after the podcast.
Do it now! Now!
Now!
Now! Do it now.
Oh, that was a flash forward.
Oh, he's punching something. A punching bag.
He's not even doing it right, huh, Sam?
No, he's really not.
His wrist. He's no Clubber Lang.
Oh, and now he's getting into it because he's taking his shirt off. Okay.
It'd be you.
I'm noticing in the background he has the news of all the bullshit going on in the world.
The bukkake of the world?
The bukkake of the world.
Bukkake.
Uh-oh, he's having a flesh eater fantasy.
Damn, some weird fantasies.
You do realize this is my biopic. This movie's about me. That's me right there, yeah.
There's my boss, Wilson. Fuck him.
It's fucking hilarious. Oh my god, this movie sounds amazing. We gotta do it on this show.
What?
Blubberella.
Yeah.
I gotta see if I can find it. When it's your pick, we should do that. It sounds interesting.
Reduce him. Oh, look, he's just fucking getting pumped up for the day, all angry. This guy's an incel, yeah. I can already tell. He's like, fuck it, I'm gonna work out in my basement. All those Chads and Stacys won't even see me.
He's like, all those woke motherfuckers out there.
Oh, look. Visions. Well, so far for Uwe Boll, Willis, I don't know.
The movie ain't started yet.
Brian, are you awake? Come for breakfast.
Oh, I'll be right down.
I'll be right back.
This dude is a good actor.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, it's Max Headroom.
Right. Yeah, Max
Headroom.
God damn, really? I forget his real name. Yeah. I just call him Max Headroom.
Matt Frewer.
Matt Frewer, yeah, that's it.
Max Headroom. I watched that when I was a kid. High as a kite. That was a good movie.
I remember the TV show.
A kid, high as a kite.
Yeah.
What do you want? Tylenol?
I used to smoke weed.
Nah, he was sniffing glue.
It was like 16. 16 when it came out. I think. I don't know. Somewhere around there.
I was still in elementary school when that shit came out. Your mother and I were talking. That was the last year. Honestly, not
for the reason. Oh, look.
That's great.
Oh, it is. It is Bill's movie. You think it's time he moved out? Okay. I think it's time you've moved out. Well, help your father. What a little shit. Yeah.
Sorry, Mom. No, it's okay. It's just you gotta get your own place, right?
I know. You gotta get your own place, Bill.
You
keep saying that, but it takes time because I have to obviously raise the money for my own post-education. Right? So the deal was is that I would be
wow, this sounds like all the kids from today.
To save up that money.
It's, meantime, it's a prequel.
Whatever, I wish. My son wanted to stay here forever. Remember when you like a weirdo?
I told my kids, fucking, hey, you know, next year's the year. What, after you graduate? You out of here!
Did they have a look of horror on their face?
I think my son terrified that I'm going to do that to him. Be like, you graduated, you're gone.
He's still got a long way to go, though.
Oh, yeah, no, he does. And I've already told him that's not how it's going to be. But he's also my only child, so, you know.
Calvin's like 15, isn't he?
No, he's going to be 13 in September.
Oh. He's got 5 years to get out of the house and figure it all out.
They grow up so fast.
Thank you.
I'm fine. I just thought, yeah. I thought we were had a good situation.
Has he been better lately?
Let's not make it a bad one. Calvin's the best.
Well, he was driving her crazy for a while, I thought.
I mean, he's my only child. And he's the only other human being in this house. So he kind of perpetually always drives me crazy. There's nobody else to drive me crazy, with the exception of the dogs and the cat.
Your animals.
And the chickens.
Oh, yeah, the chickens. Cluck, cluck. I be having fried chicken every night.
I have enough chicken in my freezer. That could be done.
I'm sick of fucking chicken. We have at work every Wednesday chicken wings. Every Wednesday chicken wings and every Friday fish. And I don't eat fish, so.
So you starve.
I love chicken wings.
No, they had something else.
They give it to you for free?
No, we got to pay for that shit.
Oh.
I pay for lunch and breakfast.
What?
Yep. At work. Yep.
You get good prices, though, right?
It all depends what it is. And then it all depends who's at the cash register.
It's not cheap to go eat anymore, that's for sure. Fucking McDonald's is expensive now.
Oh, God, yeah.
Yeah, for no reason.
I used to go in the morning and get a sausage muffin, you know, without the egg. It was like $1.69. And I'd go two times a week, whatever, went before work. And I go the other day, it went up $2.69 now. Like, holy fuck, like, that's quite a jump.
Double macchiato with extra foam.
Spend like $3, I'm spending $6.
This guy's fucking. Do you remember when double macchiatos with extra foam cost $4.50?
How much are they now?
Like fucking $10.
What?
I wouldn't say that they're that expensive, though it depends on where you go.
Oh, shit. Yeah,
it is. That's not a macchiato. Man. There's no foam in there at all.
Yeah, there is. There's some right there.
No. A lot of foam. A lot of foam. Dude, look. This is like half milk.
It's not a macchiato. It's not a macchiato. This is like Brett Flesheater on the way to work.
There you go, more foam.
I'm like, make my drink right, motherfucker.
Perfectly good macchiato.
Give me back my money, man.
I'm not giving you.
Just fucking make it, stupid.
I'm not paying for something that I didn't order, man. Give me back my money.
I make the best coffee in this town.
I don't give a fuck what you make, bro, but I didn't order this.
Oh my goodness. I would be in.
That's a good coffee. Take it.
That's a good call.
A day in the life of flesh eater. That's what this movie should be called.
This doesn't seem like a Uwe Boll movie.
No, so far, no, it's just kind of different.
Yeah.
Is he going to go insane?
Yeah.
You want to give me back my 450?
Like falling down?
No.
Yeah, pretty much, yeah. Yeah.
All right, man.
Here,
you said your favorite word, Mona. No.
Take a fucking roll with you.
Guy's like a nice fucking guy that runs a business, huh? Like, what is it? We're gonna fuck with this kid.
I wouldn't be that way myself. He's just having visions.
He runs a business and he's treating his customers that way.
Having night visions, vision. Man. Whoa.
Night visions.
He's not having it.
His name is Bill, too.
He needs to take more pills.
Lunch has been over like 15 minutes ago.
What do you mean? I took my lunch break 15 minutes ago.
Bill, take the mask off. I got tons of cars in there. I'm near
with you. Hey, man, society's just beating this dude down.
I already finished. Yeah. Three cars. Come on, get in there.
Get in there, Bill.
Maybe I should clock you, man.
What did you
He's
say?
He's just not having a good day.
I don't think you should treat your best worker like that, Jim.
Yeah, Jim.
Bill, just get in there and make some money for us,
How
okay?
about a raise?
Yeah, Bill. What'd you fuck off?
$9.
Yeah. $9.
I'd leave.
Mm-hmm. $9 leave. Raise. Dang. Mm-hmm.
$9. Fuck that. Man, could you imagine if I asked my boss for $9? Probably be like, okay. Let's see what we could do for you.
Then why don't you ask him then?
Because I'm capped out. I'm capped out in my position for the amount of money I can make, unfortunately. Unfortunately. That's not how you use those. It's bleep, 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 bleep. Boom, 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 boom.
Oh. Shit.
Shit. They're gonna go get baked.
Bacon?
You, the funniest thing is that you and this piece of shit, only you would do a burnout.
It's $300. I know you gotta work for 6 months to make that.
It's like this guy's like an angry little loser.
By the way, you gotta stop having these things sent to my fucking house, man.
These are the last ones, man.
Dude, my dad's getting pissed, okay?
And what do you say? In
this? He's having dildos shipped to his house. He's
asking my dad's gonna kill me.
What you
doing? Yeah, bro.
Mind his own fucking business.
Bro.
Whose dog is that?
No one can know. It's a surprise. Piece of shit.
Hi, Sam.
Hi, that's my corgi. I apologize. She's being a rat.
Yeah.
She stole a zucchini. And then she's barking.
Oh. I figured out, Sam, why I didn't tell nobody that I felt your tits up.
Oh, yes?
Yeah. Because I don't kiss and tell.
Oh, okay.
That's just because you couldn't remember.
Hey.
How you doing?
Let me have my excuses.
Give me, need a four-piece. Four-piece mixed meat.
Do you want the combo?
Combo.
Mixed meat. Only white meat for me.
But yet he can't move out of his parents' house.
I like dark meat better.
Yeah, I do too.
Dark meat. White meat.
Yeah.
How sweet. Dark meat.
I like gum. Yes, ma'am. I know Willis is going to spank bank that one. Sam saying I like dark meat. He's gonna think of it when he jerks off. She says she likes dark meat. She says she likes dark meat.
I like Soylent Green. It's made from people.
Like, you can buy it at the grocery store now.
Oh, Soylent Green. Every Tuesday is Soylent Green Day.
But yeah, no, there is actually like that Soylent is a company, and they have this green. either you guys totally missed that movie and you don't understand the reference that you made, or you hit marketing goals. Like, I'm not sure.
Yeah, right.
They knew what they was doing.
I don't know. People who drink that much soy, I don't give them too much credit.
Like, soy raises your estrogen levels.
About it, indicating that maybe that was a bit of a tall tale.
Tall tale.
But it is the highest natural source of estrogen in, you know, most people's diets.
Man, this everything's just getting spilled on this guy all day.
Why did he go off?
I feel like he kind of invites us, though. Like, his energy's off.
Mm-hmm.
Here's a napkin, and I'll get this cleaned up.
What's your problem?
Is there something wrong with you? Look, I'll get this replaced. That's fine.
She's upset with her life. Jesus. Can I get my money back?
Look, I'll get you more stuff, but I'm not giving you your money back.
I don't want more stuff.
Sorry, I don't step on you, but I'll just have it replaced, okay?
Lady. Well, there's going to be a lot of people on this guy's hit list.
Do you have a manager?
Yeah.
Do you have a manager?
Hey.
Don't worry.
No.
It's fine.
This is why I
don't want to
eat in
these
fucking places, man.
Yeah, these guys are fucking...
She likes it?
Dude, do you think that
these are like the guys that shoot up gyms because there's hot people that work out there.
Yeah.
Extra ranch?
Wow. Is this quality service? Hello? Hello?
What a dick.
Well, she did just throw the food all over him and that when she didn't care. I mean, I don't know. I don't think I'd be too happy about it.
Yeah, if you had the food, if you had food dumped on you for the second time today.
Yeah, and she didn't even say sorry. She just acted like whatever.
Whatever.
What's he doing? Heh, whatever.
Willis be like, bitch, you apologize right now.
He's gonna get spit chicken.
Delirious. And Ben done telling you apologize, bitch. Or should I say bitched?
Bitched. I don't get no more, so I can't. You can't get any of them memes out of me like that no more.
Why?
I'm sure we can. Just because you're not drinking doesn't mean you won't say something meme worthy.
Bitch.
You were sober when you said Dracula.
Dracula.
You know the story of Dracula.
No.
Oh, this guy's a soy boy.
That are just burning up.
Yeah. This dude's into soy.
Blah, 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 blah. Your chicken pork, right? Like, yeah, porch, man. It's just disgusting. That's all. It's just absolutely disgusting.
He loves soy. He fucking eats it every day.
Stop living. There's two kinds of people. Leavers and takers.
I don't even drink soy milk. I drink almond milk.
We need to
If you drink a lot of like alternative milks, you should look into getting an almond cow. Just
like an almond cow?
Yes.
Oh yeah. Almond titties, right?
No.
People don't. I mean, no, but you know, whatever floats your boat.
Is there such a thing as an almond cow?
Yes, there is.
Okay. They just feed it almonds. They just feed it almonds so it pees out almond milk.
It craps out almonds.
So I ate almond milk, give me a stomach ache.
Oh,
almond,
really?
Almond milk.
You're a prodigy of the world, my son. Prodigy of the world.
Yeah, this is good writing for you, Ebol.
They should just start sucking each other's dicks already.
They should.
It's like a Quentin Tarantino film right now.
Yeah.
I wouldn't go that far.
That's why Mona left Android Vision last week, because she had bad stomach from almond milk.
That's a shit. I guess I should have. I could have just took my phone and my laptop and shit it away and watched the movie.
You could have. You guys got a beater, as they call it in Albuquerque. Do they call it beaters where you guys live too?
Beater? No? Yeah, they do. Well, yeah. For me, they do.
You know, the beater car.
Sorry. Oh, I don't know.
What's a beater car?
Beater. He's got a beater.
What's a hoopty then?
Yeah, that's what we call them, hoopties.
I call it a hoopty too.
Oh, he was supposed to come home and talk to them.
I don't know no beaters.
He's supposed to talk to them about pizza.
Beater mobile.
Pizza?
He's rubbing her feet. Got some very
exciting news for you guys. What a good husband.
Told you it was a Quentin Tarantino movie. At the chicken
den. Oh, come on, Bill.
Come on, Bill.
We organized this.
I know.
We talked about
Brian's heard this conversation before.
Okay. It was like 9 hours ago.
Tomorrow.
Oh, yeah, every day.
At breakfast, and I've got some very, very exciting news for you guys.
Okay. Oh. On time for us?
Yes.
That's exciting news. Yeah, that's great. Okay, well, I will make a special breakfast.
Dude, she made him a special breakfast that morning. This time. Absolutely. Any
he's
breakfast.
A spoiled brat.
He's fucked up.
Anybody that makes a breakfast for you is a special breakfast.
I kind of figured that would happen.
Yeah.
Typical man.
Why is he resisting this so much?
I
just think he's...
When I saw him, he had already murdered
several people. Her work is written and... Oh my. This
is not the... Oh my.
Some light reading. An
interview with Michelle Hastell. He's reading Dianetics.
Have you ever read that?
No.
No. I think my dad tried reading it. I don't think he got past page 20. He just put it down. And
what is it?
He's having fucking just...
It's like... Thinking it's, of doing it, or are you having remembrance of it?
I wonder if that book thing into it. It could be some weird L. Ron Hubbard thing. I haven't read any of it. I won't lie, I kind of avoid them because I feel like Scientologists are in some crazy kind of cult.
They are.
Tom Cruise cult.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's why he's able to do all them stunts.
Yeah.
Yeah, because he's got the fairy in him. He's blessed by L. Ron.
L. Ron, it's me, Tom.
He gives him all the money I hear from his movies and shit.
Yeah. Him and his boyfriend, David Miscavige.
Oh, I've heard of him.
Yeah.
Didn't his wife and kid have to, like, try to escape from them because they were stuck?
His wife is still missing.
Yeah, his wife's missing.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
She hasn't been seen in years. Scientology keeps telling them that she's fine, but nobody's ever seen her.
He's such a creepy-looking little fucker, too.
Yeah, and the LAPD is absolutely in their pocket. Nobody's ever going to find her until it's all over. Then we need to bind
together. People need to be individuals, man. Oh, his friend's a fucking
cult leader.
His friend's a cult leader too. In what they
say and believes in. I want to be a cult leader.
You are one.
No!
No!
Sound like it's, a cat.
She's the leader of the cult of Schneider.
You won't mess with her about this. You bastard.
Some cult, two people. Wow.
Printing fake money on your actual printer. I don't think that's how that works.
I know, right?
More, the cult's got to start somehow.
The cult of personality. Focusing their time on fighting religious wars,
fighting over control of natural resources. When was this released in 2008?
2009.
2009.
I don't know. Okay. Do you have any thoughts? Oh, here we go with the fucking Charles Manson diatribe.
Everyone's gotta live. Everyone's gotta be happy. It's a joke.
You're a joke. Can't survive over the next 100 years. The facts don't lie. He's up to something like fucking the Riddler. We need
someone yeah. In what they say and believes in action, believes in positive
action. It's an absolute joke. The Riddler.
That's what you didn't get. You think people are equal? They're not.
Toasted people are equal.
I don't think people are equal. Do you, or Willis?
It all depends on the people.
Equality is impossible if you have humans involved.
Thank you, Sam.
Always. Like, there's always going to be somebody who wants more or who, you know, you can't have true equality. I would also add on to that, that that's also partially because everybody is different, and that when you're all not the same, it's impossible to all be on the same level all the time.
Right?
Oh, we're back to the bad boxing.
He's trying to be Ivan Drago.
I am so excited. So I actually set up a peanut bag in my extension of my room so I can actually punch things now. I still have to get a heavy bag stand, but that's a work in progress. So.
And why do we accept this? Because we're a society built. Well, yeah, we're only
4 months away from Christmas, so. Gifts.
Are you gonna get me a $700 heavy bag stand?
$700.
Oh, are we doing a gift exchange?
Virus will have to do that one. He's maxed out. He can buy you that.
What? Buy what?
A $700 kickstand or some shit.
I already know what I'm getting, Mona.
Cole.
I already know what I'm getting.
Cole.
Why not?
What?
Cole.
You said you didn't like. No, you said you didn't like that.
Cole?
Yeah. Oh, Bill, you got to go talk to your parents.
You said you didn't like that. No, Virus, I don't like Cole.
He's just pushed. He's an entitled little fucker, you could tell. His parents just drink orange juice every morning.
Good morning, honey.
Morning. That's really good.
I'm glad.
Honey?
Now get the fuck out.
Yeah, that's a special breakfast.
I know, but...
That's a breakfast every morning at Newty's. We've reached some kind
of agreement, right? Oh, yeah, I wish. Breakfast every morning is a Jimmy Dean croissant at work.
I'm going to stay in. I've got the day off. I'm going to fill out some college applications. And I'm thinking...
What did my ears just hear?
I'm going to fill out...
Don't tell them what you're going to do. Just do it, fucker.
Yeah.
Honey?
Who kidnapped our
Yeah.
Hey, what's going on? That's fantastic. Congratulations.
That's great. Fantastic.
Well, so you guys have I've got to say, I'm really proud of you. Really proud.
I'd be proud once he does it, because I don't believe he's doing it.
Maybe you got in there somewhere, huh?
You guys kicked my little tush.
I don't think so either.
I think he's going to go on a mass, like, murder rampage instead.
You think?
Rampage.
I wonder. I mean, you might get Rampage from a movie named Rampage?
Maybe.
This is Rampage, baby.
I knew he was going to say that. I want to see that brawl tomorrow night, the parking lot joint.
Right? Yeah.
No, Moxley's gonna bleed.
He didn't bleed last night, so.
I know, right? So he's gonna have to bleed tomorrow. It's Friday night.
Sorry about that.
Okay.
Have a good day at work, okay?
I will, sweetheart. I'm very excited for you, and I want to see how this turns out with the applications.
Okay.
Bye, baby. Bye, honey.
All right.
Bye.
People are equal, even though equal. They're not. Evan. Such an idiot.
Oh.
You're like a drop.
He's giving the fucking business to his friend.
I just poured the bucket out.
And his friend's like doing a different diatribe. Oh, yeah, he's getting ready for it.
All you could do was talk.
He's dressing like a ninja and everything.
Do anything. Yeah. You know, I guess I did.
You know, Flesh Eaters had these fantasies big time.
Oh yeah, I met every day. Yeah.
Yeah. He posted for the world to see on Facebook every day. Until he gets banned, and then it says, then it's Chet Remy that's doing it. Yeah. Or Hangzhao Lo.
Oh, he's a school shooter.
Uh-oh. There you go.
I don't like school shooters.
Me neither.
Problems.
Look at him. He's got a suit of armor.
Oh, I love him.
Damn, he's hardcore.
Oh, he's like a modern-day Batman. He's got a suit of armor and everything.
Doesn't want to be taken out right away. Still got almost an hour left. It's going to be a long rampage.
And they lead up to the rampage, and it's only 5 minutes.
That better not happen.
It's Uwe Boll, so don't be surprised.
He's getting a stealth move on.
I felt enthusiastic today, so let me put on all my armor and go out to see people.
And away we go.
This movie is almost like watching this. We need to talk about Kevin.
Oh, yeah. I've never seen that. Is it,
dude,
is
this
it good?
Does not. If it, is it just me if this does not feel like a fucking Dewey Boll movie?
No, because it's not that bad. Yeah.
I guess I don't know how many Uwe Boll movies I've actually seen, so I can't.
Oh. We can do like a fucking whole year of podcasts on this show about with Uwe Boll movies.
I know, right?
Of how bad they are. Oh, he got a fake car. Look at that. He fucking planned this whole thing out.
A fake car?
Well, you know what I mean. Like, he got a drive.
Is it made out of cardboard?
Pick your braids up off the floor.
Hey.
Yeah, he's having a bad night.
No, I'm not.
For God's sake.
Another question is he actually, like, doing this, or is he...
Dreaming it? We don't know.
Dreaming it, yeah.
Can anyone do this? Could be like Slaughter High. It was all a dream until the end when he went out and did it.
It's true.
It's true.
It's true.
I love Slaughter High.
It's a good one. The guy, you know, the main actor killed himself.
Yeah.
Wow. Wah, wah.
All talk, no action. Think he's going to go get the barista guy first?
One can hope.
Yeah.
I mean, to be fair, the barista guy was kind of asking for it.
Yeah. He was. He's a dick.
He was a dick.
This guy got money. A remote control van.
Oh, he's been saved. That's why he's been doing with all of his money. That's why he tells his parents he can't move out. He's been hoarding his money to buy shit.
A remote control van. Oh, that's dude. Pretty cool.
It's a good idea. Ooh. Right into the
police. Oh, my goodness.
Boom. I'll be back.
Ah! Yeah, right.
Dude, he just put some fucking fertilizer in that bitch. There ain't nobody in there.
Over the back!
Wow.
I don't know. If I saw that, I would run. I'd be like, shit, I'd run.
Oh, he did a good bomb. Look at that.
Damn. Jeez.
He didn't fuck around.
Man.
The CGI looked bad on it.
A little bit. Hey, it's Uwe Boll. We gotta just cut him some
slack. Yeah. Yeah. You gotta lower your expectations.
Ooh. Aw, oh, dude. He's just...
Oh, damn. We got that guy.
Oh, come on. He died and hit the brakes.
His head hit the...
Oh. So this movie has two sequels.
What? Oh, God. Why?
So, different people killing every movie?
I think it's him. It's the same one. Because I've seen the part two. I didn't know there was a third one. I knew he was trying to make a third one, but he just couldn't get the money to do it.
Well, yeah, remember he bitched at you for it?
Oh, yeah, that's right.
He wanted you to front it for him?
He's like, you're one of those assholes that won't give to my Kickstarter. Don't
you? Like, you want to see the same shitty Marvel movies over and over again.
Pink.
Did he fund these movies with Kickstarter?
Yeah.
Wow. Okay.
Get down.
I mean, I love Kickstarter, but that's entertaining.
Oh, now he's got the big guns. Hence the name Rampage. We haven't seen Mona's boyfriend yet, though.
I know, what the fuck? My pants have been off for a while now. Like, almost 40 minutes.
Just mere mention of Michael Paré and her pants drop.
Oh, he's gotten a lot of people.
Yeah.
No barista yet,
the one, he told me he's running in the middle of the street.
There's Rampage 2.
Oh, hi. Scary shit, huh?
Oh, no.
Scared as shit, huh? No fucking duh.
Here we go.
Oh, yes.
You guys fucking ruthless.
The plot, part 2, involves him holding a television station hostage. And then part 3, capital punishment. Yeah. Oh, no, part 2 was capital punishment. Part 3 was President Down. So maybe he gets out with the president.
I'm intrigued. I'm intrigued to see how this movie ends now that I know he's in part 2.
Yeah.
Fuck you, weird ass.
Fucking dicks.
At this point, shouldn't these people not be on the street anymore? I mean, he's been shooting long enough now.
Listen, he doesn't walk that fast.
He's got all fucking 1,000 pounds of armor on him. It'd be easy to outrun.
That's what I mean, like, but they should be off the street by now.
You would think they would still... know to go down the side streets and the alleys. Right. And put as many buildings between them and him as possible.
Right.
Like, being out in the open with an active shooter. is maybe not your best bet.
But if this was in DC, he'd have been dead a long time ago if he ran in the wrong hood.
Hey!
Hey, man, how are you? Oh, hey, man. You remember me?
I haven't noticed that there's a bunch of people getting shot outside.
I know, really.
Say, how are you?
The espresso machine's too loud.
Your phone. Whoa. Why don't you make it like your life depends on it?
Because it does.
Sure, man. Yeah.
Pee a little.
Extra foam, man.
You like to take your sweet fucking time, don't you?
There you go.
It's just cackling.
Why is this so difficult?
There's no foam.
I mean, how hard could it be? I'm gonna give you 5 seconds to get the fuck out of here. I'm gonna start counting right now. One.
Are you serious?
Yeah, I'm pretty fucking serious. One.
Guy's thick.
Two, hurry up, motherfucker. Run, Forrest, now you're getting it. Five, bitch.
Oh, he got him. That's the only guy I wanted to see get shot.
In the back.
Corpses laying out in the road, and he's like, "Hey, how are you?"
How's it going, man? Like, there's nothing going on out there. I've been listening to fucking Dave Matthews in my fucking barista bar.
I haven't just watched you gun down half the town. Ladies, I know there is a back door.
Dave Matthews.
Is the door just unlocked? Hello, they forgot to lock it.
He's their back door man.
Get over there. Get over there. Hey, ladies. Out of the kitchen. Go join your pretty friend. You too.
Don't shoot the pretty ladies.
Go. Who else is here?
There's no one else here.
No one?
It's just us
here. This door?
You lying bitches.
Come on,
come over here. Get down.
Fuck this little wiener guy.
He can't get pussy. That's why he's like that.
Is he an incel?
I believe so. I think he is.
I think that's what this is.
It's an incel movie.
He look like one.
Yeah. He's not an alpha. He's a little man.
Angry little man?
He's an angry little man.
Yeah.
this is where they slowed down the rampage for a little bit.
He needed to get some water. He's thirsty.
Yeah, he gets hot in that thing.
Real hot.
Just roast his brains with the thingy above him. See what happens.
Oh, look, it's Ginger Snaps girl.
Catherine Isabel.
Yeah, it's Catherine Isabel. Under
Jake.
Is that her? Oh, it is.
Yeah,
it's definitely her.
That's Jake's girlfriend.
He wishes.
Jake who?
Our podcast partner, Jake.
Jake
loves,
McCoy.
Loves his damn Catherine Isabel.
I'm getting nauseous.
Don't throw up in your damn helmet, dumbass.
That was kind of him. I don't believe it.
Yeah. He's going to go back and shoot him. I'm just kidding.
Maybe he left a bomb.
Dickhead, are you guys okay?
Just kidding.
Coming back.
Something.
He's like, psych.
I knew it.
Everyone over here. Over here. Get down.
Get down, get down.
Flashback.
Get down!
Flashbacks. You did this before, Newty?
Maybe I shouldn't have taken off my
mask. Felt like he was doing the same thing.
Been done that before. Oh, yeah, this is a Uwe Boll movie. He does stuff like that in his movies. Been done that shit.
Thanks for coming, Catherine Isabel. I guess she wasn't who she was.
Oh.
In this
movie. She's going to get the old people now.
Damn.
Well, they lived a good long life.
I guess you're right.
So when he gets the children.
There's some youngins in there.
Maybe he'll find a random World War II sniper who will just happen to have a rifle on him. And...
that would be wonderful.
But obviously, there are two more movies, so maybe not.
I can't understand how they're going to get to another movie.
Bingo.
That's a hell of a body count if he gets all these people. They're not even paying any attention to him.
He's just walking around.
They don't give a fuck.
They don't want to miss Bingo.
Bingo is very important.
A little bit peckish. You got something to eat? Why don't you get me the best sandwich you got? The best tasty sandwich.
The best,
sandwich,
huh? The egg salad sandwich.
That looks like shit. It's a nice hairnet. Can I make you wear that?
Yeah, thanks. Free of charge, just...
Oh, good. I completely forgot my wallet.
Oh, look, he's good. Can't stand this guy.
Have a good day. Is that true?
Tenderville Bingo, where everyone's a winner.
I'll play bingo.
He's just sitting down.
I'm feeling now peckish.
He's gonna take helmet again, and then he's going to have to kill everybody in the room again because he's paranoid.
Right? he found a way around it. All right.
Lucky him. That, he's probably still going to kill everybody in the room. But...
he's trying to get his energy up.
Or he's going to go shoot that guy because he gave him an egg salad sandwich and it's terrible.
I would have been
gone. I would have been gone.
Common sense is definitely not a theme in this movie.
I-27. Sir? Oh, no.
Bingo.
Sir.
Bingo? No bingo. Mm.
Yeah, I will say this guy's really hateable.
Yeah.
Oh, no, you wouldn't date a guy like this, would you?
I may have, but no.
No!
What the fuck's wrong with you?
He said, you guys don't need my help at all. He said, they already wasted their damn time. I don't need to kill them.
They're already dead. Just zombies. All right.
Then they just go back.
He didn't waste his bullets on them people. Hey, that looks like Bill's old car.
Oh, yeah.
Does it really?
Yeah.
Really?
For reals.
Ooh. Where are we going now?
Let's shoot some more cops up. Oh, this is all for... He's robbing the bank.
Oh my god, if he goes back to his parents, it's like, here's your rent money. Nobody presses the alarm.
I got you. Oh,
got you now, motherfucker.
Oh, yeah. I got the thing too.
Oh, he's a fucking hero.
I don't know why people decide to be heroes of banks, though.
I know, right?
I do got a video that this guy went into, like, in the hood, and he tried, you know, just to took a trash can, and he was emptying all the cigarettes into it in the back.
I see that shit.
Did you?
Yes!
They beat the fuck out of him.
What happened?
So some dude, like in the hood...
Out in California.
Yeah, it was in Stockton. He took a whole, like, trash can and went to this convenience store and went behind the counter and was just emptying all the trash, all the cigarettes in his bag. Get the fuck out here. And this other guy was filming, he's all... And he was telling the workers, you can't do nothing. You got insurance, you can't do nothing. They tackled him and beat the fuck out of him with a stick. They made him cry. I'm sorry.
You they beat the hell out of him with that broomstick. Oh, I was dying laughing.
Yeah, I'll post it up for you, Mona. You're going to laugh your ass off.
I think I saw that this morning.
I'm not going to lie. Like, let's be fair. You probably don't want to mess with somebody who is hired at 7-Eleven. Their clientele are questionable. Their employees are definitely questionable for the most part. Mm-hmm. Like, really? Open the safe. You have insurance? No.
Well, and I also think, like, if this was this guy's convenience store, you're fucking with their livelihood.
Yeah.
And that's, like, at a primal level, like, that's just like a caveman going to another cave and stealing his fucking hunt and his meat. So it's like, what do you think's gonna happen? You know?
Hey. Yeah, shit was funny. Calm down. He took that damn stick and beat the hell out of him.
Everything's gonna be okay. I'm not gonna kill you. I don't know why I'm not. Ooh. Is this your first time?
This is your first time getting robbed?
What the fuck is wrong with you, huh? What the fuck is wrong with you? Huh? Punch in the code!
Fine.
I got it, Frank. I got it. There it is. Fill it up.
You see? Money. It's about as worthless as you are.
He's like the Joker.
Hurry up.
Right? Hurry I'm going to burn it all up.
Please, just don't shoot. That's it. That's all of it.
Give me the fucking bag. Stay there. Thank you.
Pinhead.
He didn't kill him. He kept the promise.
Is this all for just a bank robbery? Quite possibly.
So he can finally move up.
Oh, now he's gonna set something on fire.
You're gonna burn it.
Oh.
There goes the money. It's fake money, though. This is what he was.
Oh, he was printing.
Yeah.
Oh, he's got a plan.
Swapped out the bag. Swapped out the bag in his front.
Yeah.
Good catch, Sam.
Sam, you're the smartest chick I know besides Mona.
Shut the fuck up.
And Willis. Mona, you came in second place.
Yay.
Mona's the smartest chick in Albuquerque.
That's sad.
Have a nice day!
Man, Mona, by the time you took your pants off, the guy's going to be in the movie for like a minute.
I know. Thinking of putting them back on.
Right when you do that, they'll show up.
I feel awful.
Why?
Is this movie making you feel awful?
Yeah, it's fucking violent.
I will admit, it's really not a pick-me-up of any kind.
No. You should have seen when I did with the old... It's Not Horror, when I did... what was that movie? Newty? It was like such a come-down. Rolling Thunder.
Oh, yeah.
Everybody's like, fuck.
That's like Deliverance, too. That movie is so depressing.
Oh, no. Depressing. Deliverance, too.
Yeah.
Deliverance, also.
Oh. Oh, there's your boyfriend.
Boing.
Boing.
Lady Boner.
Oh, yeah, I know.
Noah's clit just stood straight up.
Oh. Smacked her in the chin. Yeah, he had no reason.
How's he looking, Mona? Does he look all right?
Tenderville, this is Sheriff Melboy. Come
yeah,
back.
Compared to now. His voice. Love that voice. I just have to hear his voice.
What the hell's going on, Ray?
Someone's shooting up the place.
Is he going to be a hero? Is he going to get killed by this little shit?
No, what's happening?
You haven't seen anything? What happened?
No, turn on the television, honey. There's one guy, they think, killing people all over
the world.
Yes, killing people.
Crazy,
but you're fine. You're at home.
Fine, I'm just... I'm at home. Where are you?
I'm here. I'm watching it on the news at work, and it's terrible.
You're at work?
Yeah.
That's like me talking to my mom when I was fucking high on acid. Oh, I'm good. I'm at home. Everything's all right. Yeah.
When are you going to be back?
Everything's fine.
No,
I'm not fucked up.
Okay, I'll be back.
You sound funny. No, everything's good.
I'll be back.
Tired.
Just tired. My memory's slipping from me.
Okay, stay safe. All
right, baby. Love you. Bye-bye. She said she loved him like 100 times.
Well, yeah, she's his mom, even if she wants him to move out of the house.
Okay, like, baby, I love you. Baby, I love you. Baby, I love you.
Grow some balls and take care of yourself, but not yet, because there's a mass shooter.
Yeah. Uh-oh, not the chicken den. He really mad at that girl. Is he going to play with her like he did the coffee guy?
Oh, no, he's not.
Fuck, man.
Hey.
Yeah, where are you?
I'm running some errands right now, man.
What errand?
I'm coming right now, bro. Don't go anywhere, okay?
Yeah,
don't go anywhere.
Oh, he did. Just went and shot her and left.
Oh, he said, we're going to play paintball. Remember in the beginning of the movie? We're going to go play paintball, man. I bet you he's fucking going to get his friend to take the fall.
I thought that from the minute that he had the packages sent to his friend's house. But I didn't want to throw it out there because I didn't want to spoil it in case that's what happens.
Yeah! Who's the winner, Bill?
Because he kept saying, why you sent that shit to my house, you know?
Fucking kidding. Seriously, though. Seriously. You ever seen fucking Cowboys?
Still got 24 minutes.
Oh, shit. sorry to hear that.
Are you really?
Was it that bad?
Yes.
I don't know. We'll find out in 24 minutes.
We're going to go apparently blow something else up.
Yeah.
I don't think anywhere near that much explosives is necessary to blow up that sign.
It's completely necessary, Sam.
Is that a sign? By the way, are they in Tennessee?
Could be.
That would. I think that's what that sign says. I thought it was a welcome to like Tennessee or something.
This fucking kid.
Mm-hmm. This fucking kid's an asshole.
Hello?
Kevin.
Hello.
Pick up the phone, McFly.
Yeah.
Dude, you're taking for fucking
hello, McFly.
I've got a lot of shit to do today, okay? It's been a fucked up afternoon. I'll be there in 10 minutes. Don't go anywhere. Dude, all right.
10 minutes, my fucking ass. Paintball, bro. Paintball, bro.
Yeah, don't have paintball. Paintball, bro. So? We're gonna play paintball. Yeah. Give me a fucking good reason, and I want a fucking articulate reason.
Because I'm gonna go there and suck your dick.
I'm gonna fucking kill you, man. Listen, you're the one. You're gonna be mean to fucking target practice, all right? You're not gonna go anywhere, right?
Right.
Just stay there for 10 minutes, okay? I'm coming, I promise. I love you, man. All
right. Promise you, he's coming.
Okay. All right. And he is actually going to fucking kill you, so. Maybe you should. No. No.
You can go a little faster, Ray.
Go a little faster, man. Ah, oh, the fuck happened there?
Ooh. Bang bang.
That's why they made all that. This guy has got a lot of money and a lot of explosives.
For him to be broke.
4 seconds, Mona. Now.
Yay.
Okay.
Your boyfriend just got blown up. Oh wait, not yet.
No, the car in front of him got blown.
Yeah, I thought he did, but it was the other one.
Closer, Ray.
Trying to get his voice so I can get Mona wet.
did you see him in... Did we watch Bad Moon ever?
No,
oh,
but
that's
I've
a
seen
good
it.
Movie. Me likey that movie.
It's good.
Does everybody else like that movie?
Mario Hemingway's in it, I think.
It's good. I think that the werewolf changing effects are a little shitty, but...
yeah. Well.
It's mediocre.
You know, Livy actually to watch again sometimes. It's like the French werewolf movie. I think it's like Brotherhood of the Wolf or something.
I have that DVD and I've never seen it.
It's actually really good, but you have to read the whole thing.
I've never
like,
seen it either.
Is it a book?
No, it's a movie.
I thought you said it was a book, though.
No, not to my knowledge.
No, I think it's just a movie. It's just a movie.
Keep reminding yourself, it's only a movie. It's only a movie. It's only a movie.
Or is it? Or is it a movie?
It's got 73% on Rotten Tomatoes, so I guess I can't suggest it for this particular show. But
oh, the cops are after him. Get him. So I would say this is more a cameo Michael Pare.
Yeah.
Oh.
Damn.
Oh, and he's a cop.
Pew. Yeah.
You know what that means?
What?
He likes to beat his wife and cheat on her.
I was just going to say he's going to beat me.
And belittle his sons at baseball games. At Little League games and football games.
Yeah, your favorite time of the year is coming soon.
Hey, I've calmed down.
Football starting tonight, actually.
Don't get me
Pre-season
started.
Preseason games tonight.
I really calmed down.
The occasional slip up.
I have the occasional slip up, but I've been on a good run, Newty.
Like today when you posted Scream Sucks Cock for no fucking reason.
Oh, Scream Sucks Dig. Because, for no reason. Also, do you want to know why I did that? Because I said something in the group a long time ago about Scream, like because I rewatched it and I just said, this sucks. Like, you can't. And fucking the cuck Dan, the cuck Chase said, oh, it's so edgy. And then I was like, and then I saw my name was changed to the edgy one. And I was like, I did that long ago. So I assumed he did it. So I was like, fuck that fat piece of shit and his fucking fat fucking wife. So I said,
hey, be nice. Come on.
No, fuck them. Fucking be nice to them. He's a fucking pussy, bro. So he's a fucking, like, one
pussies
of those guys.
Pussies are strong.
Well, pussies are strong. He's
not.
Whatever. He's got a fucking he's got a tiny wiener anyways. So I already seen it through his underwear when he had his fucking shorts down. It's like a little acorn. But, like, but it was like, bro, like, why do you get so hurt if somebody doesn't like the movie you like? Like, they take it personally. Like I fucking kicked their dog personally. It's like, you guys are fucking stupid. So, anyways, I thought they'd change my name, so I changed my name to Scream Sucks.
No, that was me. And I had done it.
Oh, well, it's your fault then.
I had done that a long time ago. You've been that. Your name's been that in there forever.
Oh, okay. I just noticed.
You did something. I forget what the fuck you did. And I said, ooh, edgy. And then I changed your name.
Edgy. Yeah. I am the edge, bro. What's wrong with that? What's wrong with being edgy? The cutting edge.
Yeah, straight the edge.
The cutting edge. Oh.
You ready?
What the fuck? Is that what you took fucking hours doing?
Glad you didn't leave, buddy.
He's going to do it. Moody figured it out.
Yeah.
What the fuck? Check it out.
The minute he said, why are you sending this to my house?
Real money.
I kind of thought, okay.
Where the fuck did you get all this fucking money?
It doesn't make me a genius, though, because a lot of movies are like that.
Oh.
Oh. Just shocked him.
He just tased him.
Give me your hand. He gonna frame him.
Yep, now we know how he get a part two.
Yeah.
Mm.
Gotta ask for it, right?
Since nobody knew who exactly was under the suit.
I'm sorry. Tasing yourself doesn't, or tasing somebody doesn't knock you out like that.
And he shot him in the head with his.
Well, he put his hand in the trigger.
Make it look like a suicide.
Well, he made it look like a suicide.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Suicide.
This little cocksucker.
I know.
I feel like the person. This movie and potentially participated in this movie probably both need therapists if they don't have them.
It's fucking Uwe Boll.
Definitely.
Yeah, it's 14 years ago, so they've probably got help by now.
Actually, the last movie that I saw this guy in wasn't half bad, and he played twins. Psychopath twins. I'll tell you what it was. It was actually pretty good. It had fucking a lot of actors in it. It had Superman in it, too.
Which one?
Henry Cavill, the only good Superman there was. Yeah.
I will admit, I'm not really a Superman fan, and Superman is not my favorite role that he played, but...
I was not until I saw him as Superman.
He does play a good Superman, it's just I don't like Superman in general. Like, I'm like, I don't dislike Superman, but he's just, like, he does nothing for me.
He was a good Superman in some shitty-ass movies.
No!
No!
Yes!
I like those movies.
All he was fucking Goku from Dragon Ball Z fighting. That's all he was. He wasn't no damn Superman.
I don't watch cartoons.
He ain't saved nobody.
Because I'm an adult.
I'm a grown-ass woman who don't watch no cartoons.
You're going to make Willis cry.
He ain't saved nobody's ass in that whole movie. He killed more people than he saved.
Look at his man-ass, Mona.
Ew.
Okay, it's called...
Little White Ass.
It's called Night Hunter.
Night
from
Hunter.
From 2018. It's got Henry Cavill, Ben Kingsley.
Oh, wow.
Alexandra Daddario.
Never heard of it.
Stanley Tucci.
That's a good cast.
This guy, Brendan Fletcher. Nathan Fillion's in it.
Oh, really?
Ooh. It's a stacked movie, bro. I just feel like it probably just didn't hit big at the box office. But yeah, Night Hunter.
Hmm.
Actually watched it with Ray. It's pretty good. We've been bored as fuck watching these fucking Amazon straight to Amazon movies.
Cool.
What?
Who's watching straight to Amazon movies?
Me and Rachel lately.
What did you watch?
We watched this one. What's the other one we watched? It was actually pretty good. Marauders. With Batista.
Oh, I watched They Clone Tyrone. That's what I watched last.
Oh
yeah, I saw that.
Uh-oh. Here he goes. Diatribe.
Clone Tyrone.
That's all right. Just too long.
That same thing my mom said. She said it was all right, but it was just too long.
You're just like, shut the fuck up already. Okay, I get it.
What if he did all this so he doesn't have to move out of his parents' house?
I feel like that's what's gonna...
Don't ever leave. We love you.
You're okay, though. Yeah.
There you go.
You know who she almost sound like? She sound like Bobby's World Mom. Don't you know? Bobby, don't you know?
Oh, yeah.
That means they're Canadian. That was Canadian.
Oh.
Evan got shot? I bet.
Friend Evan. No.
Evan did it. My friend.
Oh, no.
Shot? Who's my friend?
Guy's such a jerk.
He's a psychopath.
How did they find him? Like, what, did he give himself up?
They just found him in the woods. He shot himself in the
head. He's dead?
It's my friend, and I have no feelings.
This world is a crazy place, isn't it?
He's a fucked up kid.
He's a fucked up kid.
See the look he gave his father?
Mm-hmm. I mean, I'm just an armchair psychologist, but...
I'm just an armchair psychologist.
My mother knows.
My mother knows.
Nevertheless, it must be a shock for his parents.
Don't you know, Bobby, don't you know?
I won't ask about the college applications now. It all seems so trite, I guess.
Little fucker.
See, now
she's...
Oh, we're fine. Both owners and customers were victims. Presently, the union... This is where I drove by. I told you I saw that poor woman.
Do you think it's Mrs. Blakesley?
Oh, no.
You know what? I didn't want to stay around long enough to find out.
Guys, I'm so tired. I don't want to sleep.
Oh, of course.
You've had a rough day.
I'm really sorry about your friend. I'm really sorry.
He's like 30. He looks like he's 30.
I know, right?
He's like a baby.
Little man.
Give us a shout if you need anything, okay?
All right. Take care, guys.
Yeah, sweetheart. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Are they going to cry for him? For sure, after this, he's
going to have to go talk to someone. We shouldn't kick him out yet.
Just, I don't want anyone to know that we're taking him. Just so, yeah. I don't want people to know that he's enough. Crazy or
something. This guy's got a drink or something. Huh?
Yeah.
Maybe a double.
The American dream right there, man. Just detached parents.
They're in Canada.
Are they?
I don't think so. I'm pretty sure that was Tennessee. Is what that sign.
She has a Canadian accent.
That's not really Canadian. That could be Midwestern, too.
Yeah. Where, Sam lives, that's how they sound.
I just looked it up. British Columbia, Canada.
Oh, that's okay. Where this is filmed.
You gotta know what you hate.
Hello.
Oh, no. Close sources reveal that Lloyd Drinks used to be a radical and oh, he did keep the money. You see that?
Yep.
Like, fuck it. I got away with my perfect plan. With the current evidence that his son Evan Drinks has been identified
as being behind the massacre in downtown. Framed, locked his daddy up too. Damn.
Ooh.
But as soon as he spend that money, the money gonna be traced back to him.
Right.
Not if he buys a bunch of drugs with it and then fucking resells the drugs. Then he washed it clean. Just watch. What's that one movie where they wash a lot of money? That show.
Tricky Bad.
Ozarks.
Oh,
that made me nervous, that show. Did you think that was as good as Breaking Bad?
Not as good, but it was up there. It was really good. It was a good show.
Uh-oh, there's his diatribe. It's a flesh eater rap.
Yeah.
7 million people every
it is.
Year are brought into this earth. What are they doing? Sucking up our resources. There's too many people, so what do? Just keep them around?
Then you should just kill yourself.
Let's get rid of them. Good. Thank you. Thanks for coming out. But you know what? We're at capacity. We're at capacity.
That's our borders.
What happened to my boyfriend? No more. Nothing? No
more. Yeah,
dead.
He died? I missed it? What the fuck was I doing?
I don't know.
Masturbating?
Playing with your pussy?
He must have been,
But his, like, he got two bombs blown up right next to him. So.
And he got stabbed, too.
Ooh. And he got stabbed in the back.
Oh, okay. I missed that part. I was petting my cat. Like
she was that what you call it? Too?
She was you too, huh?
This show brings all the pussy out.
Oh, he's an exterminator. His own planet. What a nice guy.
That's it.
Bill Williamson. This is the same movie.
Oh.
Here.
Well, there you have it, guys. That was 2009's Rampage. Written and directed by Uwe Boll. Because Flesh Eater didn't give to his Kickstarter for Rampage 3. He was pissed at him. was it really that bad? I mean, it's pretty low budget. It was probably one of the better Uwe Boll movies I've seen. So
yeah. Well, yeah.
I'll go
for
first.
Uwe Boll.
Yeah, I'll go first. Was it that bad? I mean, there's a lot of fucking plot holes, for sure. Pretty predictable, I would say. I don't know. It seems like he's trying to make some fucking type of political fucking point in this movie. It didn't really, like... I don't know. It wasn't that bad, I don't think. So there you go. So who's going to go next?
I'll go next.
Go ahead.
So... The
problem that I have with this movie is not that it's low budget and not that he's trying to make a political point, but when, like, I mean, I guess if you just like major downer movies that are just about killing people for no reason or because you feel like you have some right to, then it's gonna be fine. But there's just no redeeming qualities in anybody in this movie. Like, there's no reason to feel in any way attached to them, to feel in any way bad for them, to feel in any way they're not necessarily even relatable. It's just kind of like they're all shitty people. And, yeah. So, yeah, I really didn't exactly enjoy it.
Yeah, she didn't like it. It wasn't that well. Was it that bad though? You didn't enjoy it, which is understandable. But was it that bad?
Like, if I had to rate it on a scale of 1 to 5, I'd give it a 2.
Oh, okay.
So, all right. Less than 50%.
So it was bad. All right. All right, Willis, it's your turn, sir.
This movie is pointless. Pointless as fuck. All it was white dude going around shooting up at other white people. Basically, the movie in a nutshell. And it's Uwe Boll, so what you expect?
Mm-hmm.
It ain't nothing more or nothing less than another long line of bullshit ass Uwe Boll movies.
Yeah. The only good part about it was the white people killing the white people, huh?
That wasn't even thrilling.
More white people. I'm just kidding. Kill all the white people. Kill Whitey. I'm just
Where
kidding.
Where are the white women at?
All right. Fleshy.
Let's see. It's definitely not a movie to watch if you're in a depressed mood. For Uwe Boll, it was better than like movies like House of the Dead or Alone in the Dark. It didn't have no storyline to it, just random killing. I guess if you're a mentally disturbed person, even more mentally disturbed than I think you'd enjoy it, but, I think if you're just like, on a scale of 1 to 10, I'd probably just give it a 3.
Oh, so it was
kind of bad. So I don't know. I'll leave it at that.
There you go. Newty.
I feel bad to say, but I didn't hate it. Enjoy it. I mean, the movie itself is a downer, but I kind of, watching it and having a good time, I guess I just liked it better. Maybe if I watched it alone, I wouldn't like it, but I don't think it's that bad.
All right. Miss Monotone.
Uwe Boll's falling down. Was it that bad, but I was just pissed off throughout the whole movie because guy's a little shit killing people.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she had her pants off the whole time and he didn't show up till the end.
I know. And then he died and I even missed that. And I guess it was the ending wasn't cliche. Cops come, kill him, save the day. It's not a good ending. So it wasn't that bad, but I didn't enjoy it and I'll never watch it again and I won't recommend it. And I might tell some people about it. That's about it.
Well, I wonder, so would you watch like 2 or 3?
If I had to for a podcast, yes, but not on my own.
If I have to.
I should ask Alexa if this is a good movie. Alexa, is Rampage a good movie?
What is it?
It has an iron rating of 6.9. I don't know what the hell that means. It said it's a popular movie on IMDb.
Oh, and I like this guy's review. He said this is the go-to movie for 14-year-old boys to watch while they're grounded or when their parents won't give them money to go to the Disturbed concert.
Let's see, can you hear this?
On the line with us, Mr. Chris?
Yes. Yep. Hello.
Oh, is that it?
Yep. Yes. You're one of these people who don't give to my Kickstarter either, right? You're too busy just lazy, lounging around the house, doing nothing all day, just being a lazy piece of trash. To be
if you want to watch the same old shitty Marvel movies over and over again.
So, all right, guys, that was Rampage 2009 for Is It Really That Bad? And it looks like the common consensus was it was pointless fucking killing, loose fucking conjointed plot, very predictable, like a wannabe fucking falling down. Mona was right. I agree with her there. So, all right, that's it for us. We'll see you on the next fucking show. I don't know whose pick it is, but we'll figure it out.
I think it's mine.
Oh, have you picked your next movie for Is It Really That Bad?
I have not. It'll be a surprise.
Okay.
Either that or number 9 is alive. Oh. I gotta make you guys watch it.
No, dude.
No.
You're probably not gonna be there that night.
Oh,
I'm
no. That ain't happening, dude.
He's gonna retire that night.
That shit happens.
I fucking dude. I listen. If I couldn't stand that movie at fucking 8 years old, what the fuck makes you think I'm just going to stand it my age now?
Well, how about we do E.T.?
Oh. No, that movie is long as shit.
So, Short Circuit. I watched Short Circuit before.
Yes, Short Circuit. Okay. That's my pick. Damn it, Short Circuit.
Johnny Five.
So join us next time for Fisher Stevens and. Johnny,
I'm gonna disassociate that night.
Oh, dude, I'm gonna be fucking.
I don't know. Like, it's got a 6.6 out of 10 on IMDb.
Yeah,
I don't
yeah.
think that it's a bad movie.
Fuck that movie.
I'm gonna pull that card. You have pulled that card on.
All right, you know what? Then I'll just do it on the. When is my pick on our other show? Then. So I'll pick something else for this one.
You all should right. fucking pick, like, Billy the Kid versus Dracula.
Yeah,
or...
you should pick that one. It's your next pick.
You know what? You should pick Gay Dracula. I would rather watch Gay Dracula, gay porno, than fucking...
Gay than fucking... We all know that.
...than Johnny Five. And I don't even like gay porn.
Mm-hmm. All right.
All right. Good night.
Good night, everybody.
Fuckers.
Later. Bye.
Fucking cells.
Is it really that bad? You've been listening to the Intestinal Fortitude Podcast Network. Follow us on Twitter, I_Fortitude, or on Instagram, The Intestinal Fortitude.